most of the time we will be using the annotation tools. But if you see, we are using Zoom, we are using WebEx, we are using Microsoft Teams or Google Meet. So different things have different annotation tools. So we sometimes get lost, okay? So instead of that, you can use your own annotation tools, okay? So the annotation tools, there are so many of them. One of the easiest ones that is free is the EpicPen, okay? So I think we have shared the details for installing the EpicPen. Or if you do not know, simply go to Google and say download EpicPen. Okay, so you can go to the epicpen.com website. And click on download. So there is a free version and also a paid version. I think most of the features that you have in a free version is good enough. So this is a comparison. Some of the features that are not there in the free version are screen cropping and all those things, but you can manage, okay? So you can click on the download now option and just download this file. Once it is done, it is just a matter of clicking on next and install. That's all, you'll be there, okay? So to start the EpicPen, either you can add to your status bar or you can go and do the search window. Okay, so you can use this. So this is the icon for EpicPen. So it gives you a floating window. Okay, so a lot of times the first time users will have a little confusion because when I try to drag it, it will show a frame actually. Don't worry about it, just ignore it. Okay, so you can keep it at a convenient place. Okay, maybe to the right extreme. Since it's a vertical one, you'll be better off using either the left extreme or the right extreme. Okay. So all basic features are available. First of all, if you want to minimize, you can just minimize it, okay, with eye shut, or you can open it and keep it long. So you have all the basic features. You have the cursor, you have the pen, you have the eraser, undo, clear all drawings. You can also add some clips, okay? So menu items are there. You can take snapshot of pictures as well. Okay, the screenshot also can be taken, okay? So this is a very efficient and very simple tool. And you also have a color palette. You can choose the colors. Okay, so if you want to use for writing, you can use that. Okay. So you can use these things. Okay. So I'm sure all of you are already comfortable with the native annotation tool with Zoom or Google Meet. So you can add this to your repertoire. Okay, you can use this as a permanent tool for annotation. So it's very helpful because that is one thing. And Madam was also explaining about the flashback recorder. So one other very efficient tool that is available that has come very recently is the Windows screen recorder, okay, with voice, of course. So all you have to do is you press the Windows button and press G, Windows G. Let me close this. So I'm going to do the Windows G now. Windows key will be there in your keyboard plus G. So on the top, you can see the recording panel, okay? So this allows you to record your screen. So it includes voice, it includes the live dynamic screen movement. It is just as good as a video, okay? So you can record it and you can play it back and it saves in MP4 and other formats, okay? So you can have other controls as well, the voice control and the widget menu, etc. Okay. So you can explore this, okay? So if you don't want to download or install the flashback recorder, you can use this. Flashback recorder is actually very powerful, okay? So I don't know how long it is going to be free,
because with such nice features, after some exposure, they may put a small price tab on that. Okay. All right. So that is one thing. And I think Madam will be explaining about Kahoot. Okay. I'm just going to add